suspended our search. And so what that means is that what we have covered in the area we searched with our assets based on the information that we had about the incident and what potential trouble they might have had, we thoroughly searched the surface of the water, and if there was anything on the surface of the water, our effectiveness of our search assets and in the area we searched and the amount of time we searched to take into consideration time and weather and winds and currents, we do believe that, you know, it's highly likely that we would have found anything on the surface of the water during that time. And so once we get to the point where, you know, continuing to search was not changing, you know, the outcome and had very little likelihood of making, you know, coming up with a different result, we got to the decision point where we needed to decide to suspend our search because continuing to look was not yielding any different result.
Do we know that they actually made it a certain distance out onto the lake? I mean, I know you found a trailer. But is there anything that gives you guys any kind of confidence they actually made it onto the lake and maybe out into the lake from the canal or something?
We do know that they did get underway based on a couple of items. We had some footage from a camera near the launch site, and we also have the information from the cell phone pings that we've been talking about. So the Air Force, they have a capability that will provide data of time and location where cell phones are transmitting. And so we had that information to that did give us confirmation that they were in the bay there fishing that afternoon, early that afternoon. So that was our best, most relevant piece of data for the search. And aside from that, we did not have a lot of information on what they were doing that afternoon. But that piece of data, we are certain, you know, the Air Force, their forensics are, they're pretty high tech and, you know, something that is used during these type of situations, a search and rescue. So that that was very good information to let us know that they were fishing early that afternoon and was the basis for our search effort.
Do we know whose cell phone it was and or if it just stopped pinging? I don't know what cell phones do necessarily, but...
Yes, we do have both cell phones and similar location data and similar time where they stopped transmitting.
Well, three people, one person disappears is one thing, but three people and a boat and no trace? That I've just never heard of it in Lake Superior since I've been here 30 years, but I know never to say never.
Right. You know, these are big waters. You know, they're and it's cold. It's dangerous. And while it is incredibly uncommon to not find any debris, I personally have had a similar experience before of a case that I not myself, but my boss was running in northern Lake Michigan. So I have seen this happen on the Great Lakes. But I agree, you know, we are all agree that it is unusual not to find any debris. But at the same time, our, you know, I know we've talked at length about the number of assets we had on scene and the type of capabilities and the objects on the surface we were spotting, you know, sticks and, you know, little lots of objects, the small metal bucket, you know, we were finding objects on the surface and, but, you know, none that were associated with this vessel.
And are you hoping people will continue to search shorelines or what's the most productive thing at this point?
Any shoreline, objects on the shoreline that, you know, do appear to be debris that could be associated with this, we can certainly go out and take a look, and that is definitely still appreciated if people have that kind of information, and we have been getting those reports over, you know, since since last week, and as the case was ongoing. So we do appreciate all the eyes on shore, and those can continue to be reported. And you know, we would really, you know, our hearts go out to these families, and if you know we can find anything else to help us, you know, come to a, you know, greater resolution on this, we would certainly appreciate that information.
Is still the most reasonable, unless some evidence develops, explanation that it's going to be, for lack of a better word, an accident, as opposed to like foul play or anything like that?
You know, I really can't speculate on that. If there's anything like that, it would not be in our hands. Our portion of the investigation was just, you know, trying to find them on the surface of the water. And, you know, we really did our best in working that angle out to the fullest extent. Any other possibilities, I can't even begin to speculate. We searched a total of 14,696 square nautical miles of Lake Superior, and you know, we used our assets from stations Marquette and Portage, air stations Traverse City, Detroit, Cape Cod, Elizabeth City, the Coast Guard Cutter Biscayne Bay, RCC Trenton, our Canadian partners, and of course our state and local partners, as well as all of the eyes we had on shore, and sending reports our way, which we can't quantify that portion. We've searched a total of 144 hours, and that was the total of our search effort. I just want you know, the families to know how much, you know, our hearts are with them, and that, you know, we really put our best effort into this search, and our thoughts are with them.